Hello everyone and welcome back to Minecraft. Now if you haven't already seen it, go and check out the boss battle video because this video today is going to explain kind of what I did and how to make your own. It's very, very simple. The mod that I used to do this was Custom NPCs mod. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to grab us here. Let's just go into creative mode. Game mode 0? Nope, that's game mode 1. I always get those mixed up. There we go. This is just the remainder of all the stuff I was wearing for the battle video. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to get us the cloner. The reason I'm getting the cloner is because I've already actually made one mob. And I'm going to get us the wand. Here, the NPC wand, the NPC cloner. So if I just pop this cloner down, you can see that we've already got some. These are ones that I've already made and saved, and I can add them whenever I want. I'm going to add this one. I don't know how to remove these exactly, because the remove button doesn't really do anything. But if I spawn one in, here we go, you can see the boss that I have made. Now, I'm going to get my NPC wand here. I'm going to right-click. Because it's kind of big and it's very hard to get the spot, I think if you click around here, there we go. We're going to get it. But if you don't worry about it. Just click away, right click, select what you want to edit. In this case, that one, and edit. There we go. So what I did, well, to make it big for a start, I made it size 30. Just a quick thing I want to say, because some of you didn't know how to get this model inside of Custom NPCs mod. What you have to do is you have to go to model and edit. And if you've got the latest version, it should be something like this where you can scroll through. And you have to scroll all the way through to this one, NPC Crystal. And then we go to Select Texture. And then when we go through our custom thing, we can see here we have Crystal. And inside here, we have a bunch of different crystals. So in this case, what did I use? I think it was the Electric Crystal Floating. There we go. So one without the base. Now, of course, you can actually find these textures inside of the Custom NPCs mod. And you can change them and add your own. But these are the ones that come as standard. So there we go, we can see there's our electric ball, our lightning crystal ball. So, there we go, down there. So that's how you get that, that's pretty simple. To hide the name, just using hide. I'm not going to go through a guide to everything. Here's what I did with the health, very simple. In order to get it to work as a boss and as a mob, you need it to be in either a neutral or aggressive faction. The reason I chose neutral was that it would attack me only when I attack it. There are some controlling things that you can change between them, but it's also how you can make mobs attack other mobs that are all custom NPCs. You just have to put them into a separate faction. So I put this into a neutral faction, which means that it would attack me back. So along here, we can see on AI, I've had on found enemy, I've set it to retaliate. I've also changed a bunch of things here. I've made sure that the moving type was set to standard and the animation was normal, rotation was manual, so that it wouldn't spin around, because it's meant to be a ball that just bounces up and down, and if it spins around it does look a bit odd, so I got rid of that as well. Now originally when I planned this, I didn't plan to have punch on my arrow and make it fly along. It was meant to stay up there the whole time, but that didn't really pan out. It did actually come round down here before I killed it. So that was one thing that you have to consider. Actually, in here, you can go to resistance, and I did actually put the knockback resistance up, but I don't think it seemed to have made much of a difference at all. But you can make these mobs kind of, I made it very resistant to melee and make it more so it was standard to arrow, so it had to be a ranged fight. So if we go to ranged options, we can see that we've got a bunch of things, accuracy, the range. You can kind of copy these if you want, but it should be very similar to as it comes as standard. All I did was I knocked the accuracy down just a bit because it was hitting me pretty much non-stop and I died very quickly. Although, in the actual boss fight, it turns out that I was much better than I was in my practice runs where I died a lot. So, yeah. What I did, if we get a projectile type here, I set the power to 10, size to 10. That I think that's actually the largest size, and speed to 20. That is going to be the speed of how long it takes for the projectile to hit you. Power is going to be, I think power 10 is one heart, I believe. Possibly two, I'm not quite sure. And punch would obviously be the knockback that would knock you back. I thought it was just way too difficult to have that with punch. I was just being knocked back so much that I couldn't even hit it with a bow. So what I did for the cool thing, if I just go and I'm going to attack it. So I'm going to grab the emerald bow. We're going to set the game mode to, there we go, survival. And I'm going to hit it. Hang on, here we go. No, it's actually not going to work. Oh, there we go. Obviously, it's very bad at aiming. There we go, and he's now firing projectiles at us. As we can see, these are really cool 3D projectiles. Now, these are actually very simple, and you can make the projectiles look like anything. If we just set our game mode back to creative mode, so he's not going to attack us here. What I did was, inside here, I set this holy spell item into his ranged thing. Now, if I was to get something, let's go a bit silly here and get a flower. Hang on, we're going to have to get it inside the crafting menu. For some reason, in some of the maps that I make, it doesn't give me the access to any eye. If you know how to fix that, please let me know. Let's just grab track. I don't know what's going to happen with this, but we're just going to grab track. I'm going to pop that in there. And if we go out of here, we're going to make him attack us again. And he should, instead of firing these cool electric things that I'd found, these are actually the holy spell part is actually from the custom NPCs. So these are some things that are added for this purpose. But if we jump out of here to game mode zero, I'm going to remember these one day, and hit it. It should. Whenever, I don't know why that's not hitting. There we go. Look, he's now firing train tracks at us. So I guess if you were to make a model, I don't know, a train driver. I don't know why that's not hitting. Something's not quite right there. But it did work in the video and should work normally. It just seems, as soon as I come around to making a tutorial video, it all just seems to not work. There we go. I don't know why that's not hitting. But look, as you can see, the projectiles are these train tracks here. And yeah, this is on 40% accuracy, 20% speed. Oh god, okay, let's get out of this. Game mode 1. Right, let's go back to editing him again and go back to here. So that's how you would set that. Now if we go to projectile type, you can see that we've got it on spins, sticks, that's going to make it stay in the ground, spins, just a cool fancy thing, and we've got it on 3D. We can also have it on 2D. We can also have some effects. Trailing types, this is the little particles that's going to come out as it flies. It flies out a bit too quick for you to notice it, but it's a nice little extra that you can have there. There we go. Smoke, portal, whatever you want. We've got effects, so it can also add fire effects, poison effects, hunger, weakness, slowness, nausea, and blindness, and the wither effect. We can also make it explode, small, medium, and large explosions, if you want that. We can also have it on gravity, which means that it will kind of fall down. Constant means it's just going to go straight as an arrow, not fall down at all, just directly at you. Whatever it aims at, it's going to hit you. Gravity means it's going to slightly curve down towards the earth and make it a bit more realistic. But for this fight, I didn't want that. But we're going to set that on just so we can see in a minute. We've got a ranged options. We also have the fire rate and burst count. These are going to, you can play around with these. That's just going to be how often it fires. Here we go, we have the delay between 10 and 50. And the burst count is 10, so we can put this up to 50, perhaps. One thing to note is I also had this sound. That sound you can hear is actually the large blast from a firework. Right, let's jump back in. If I do game mode S, is that going to work? Ah, there we go. Why did I just use that? And we hit him again, when we actually hit him. Come on, there we go. Okay, oh my god, right, it's actually going to explode. There we go. You can see what I mean. Wow, I should have used that for the boss match. That is incredible, but absolutely impossible. And look, because I've set the burst count up to 50, all that time was just one burst. And then it's going to have that small amount of time again, and it's going to shoot another 50. So that's why I set it to 10, so we can kind of get through a burst quickly. That is incredible. And there we go, because we changed the particle effects of the portal one, we've now got the portal particles, as you can see, going along there. Right, game mode C. Whew, that's jumped us out. Okay. Right, what else do we have here that we can set this? Boss bar. This is what this bit at the top here is that says that it's a boss. We can set that to show when attacking, hide, everything else like that. I had that set to show, and that's how you can count the health there. But I also have the counter you can see in the top left there from the damage indicators mod, because I thought it would be much better to see how much damage I was doing. Which was very helpful for the fight, and also I could see how long there was in numbers, not just in a graphical bar. But I think that is all there actually is to it. There's lots of things you can do with these. There are so many different things that you can do. You can make new factions. It's such a huge in-depth mod that it's just impossible to show it in one video, and actually one of my most popular videos is showing off this mod. But I still didn't cover everything in that video. I only covered basics, and in this one, I'm just going to show you how to do the boss fight. And I guess that is it. That is all you really need to make a boss fight. You can make it whatever character you want. You can make it fire whatever you want. You also don't have to have it working on ranged fights. You can go back into here. Look, we can use range attack. It's going to range attack us until one. So I made it to pretty much always range attack. But we can also make it so it will always... Okay, I could have just done that, really. But there are ways that you can make it so it can leap at you. All these different things. It can avoid water if it's going to chase you. Could it get affected by cobwebs? Can it sprint? Does it have to see the target in order to attack? I set that one to no as well. There are so many different functions that you can do. So many different boss battles and boss mechanics that you can create with this thing. But I made quite a simple one, but I just liked it. We can have all the projectiles and stuff. I thought it was pretty cool, so I thought I'd show you guys. But that is it. Oh my god, look at all the arrows that stuck in me. That's one thing. Although it counts a projectile and you can see it as the cool projectile, the game still treats it as if you're being hit by an arrow. So that's why I've got loads of arrows in me. It's just the way that the game works, because it's still based on Minecraft, so it's still going to have those things. Sadly, it doesn't have those really cool projectile things actually sticking inside of you. But there we go, guys. That is it. If you've enjoyed this video, please let me know by rating, commenting, and subscribing. And I'm always playing around with this mod, so if there's anything you see in one of my videos and you think, how did you do that? Let me know in the comment section below, and perhaps I'll do a little tutorial video on it. But there we go, guys. Thank you very much for watching, and I'll see you all next time. Goodbye!